Hello and welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the If I Produced For series, where we go over producers and artists that I love, and we're going to learn a lot from their styles. Today we're going to focus on Ronnie J. Ronnie J is a really cool style because he's one of those producers and artists that when you hear the beat, like when you hear somebody else's song, you realize like you like all these songs, and then you look at the credits and you're like, oh, Ronnie J produced this. This is why I like all these songs. And that's a good producer to me, when you like all these different artists and it just leads all the way back to the producer. So that's what Ronnie J has done in many of my playlists. So let's start with the 808, because this is going to be the most unique approach to 808s that you're probably not used to, which is using parallel processing. Let's go to BusyWorksBeats.com. Let's go to the 808 drums, 808 science drums. And let's just pick an 808, like DNA. Now, here's where we're going to get really esoteric, but also this is where you have the most freedom creatively. So let's right-click, edit an audio editor. Okay, so now we're going to go to the tab right here. What is this tab called? So I know what it's called next time. Whatever, let's call it the region tab. Not sure what that, or the time marker tab, detect pitch regions. It's going to tell us the key. So it's G sharp. Go back to your 808. Go to your envelope tab. Reset your root note and right click on G sharp. And that will tune it. The one thing I like about Ronnie J is that he experiments with his 808s and doesn't care if it's not super boomy or super like perfect. He just makes a creative 808. And that's what I respect. And we need people like that who make it cool to experiment, because you don't want to get stuck in the middle with that simple 808 that everybody uses all the time. So let's just go to 144 BPM. And let's start with a bass line. Usually I don't start with bass lines. Now his bass lines don't really have a lot of jumps, like octave jumps, but let's add some just for my own taste. Then I'm gonna go 1-2-3. So just something simple, just kind of keeping that core bass line going up an octave. Now here's the fun part. We're going to go to mixer channel 1, left click to send a duplicate. Let me call this duplicate. I spell duplicate without a T. But here's the duplicate sent to mixer channel 2. Now here's where we get to stack a bunch of effects and be super creative. So I accidentally did that, but let's open up. Trying to think, do I want compression first or do I want distortion? Let's do compression first and then we'll get into distortion. So let's load up a Fairchild compressor. Where's our Fairchild at? Here we go. I always mix these up. Okay, 670 is the one I want. And now I'm gonna crank it and then change the output so that we're pushing really heavily through the compressor. I haven't used this in a while, so I can't really see either. So I'm trying to see where the output knob is. Here we go, right, left, output. So I'm gonna turn the output down, but crank the input gain. And then lower the threshold so it picks up a lot of the signal. And let's see if we can boost the input a little bit more. Now you can go, let's add an EQ. Now I'm trying to boost it so we can get a weird kind of, now you can hear that buzz. So it's different than distortion. I mean, as far as like your typical plugin. Now keep in mind, both of these frequencies are stacking up. So you gotta be careful with your volume too, your leveling. So you can get super creative. I'm going to add a distortion plugin before the compressor, even though we've already driven the signal, just to show you how far you can take it. Let's do the Culture Vulture. One of my favorite distortion saturation plugins for 808s. You can try out, let's do overdrive. And now you can see we're just getting different tones. But we didn't affect the original 808, so it's not like super lost. So, I mean, we can do that till infinity. If you distort it too much, it just turns into a square wave. Change the bias. So it either focuses on high frequencies or lows. Pull the gain up. Well, we don't have any more, do we? Now, some people even add reverbs and like stereo separators to the duplicate track to widen that out. You can do that as well. I'm going to use Cooper Time Cube. You can use any stereo plugin. Where are we at here? Cooper. I'm just going to show you how wide it gets out. And you can turn the mix level down. Let's get a little more brightness out of it. Okay, so now we have a super unique 808 stack. And then you can combine these two. Call it 808 stack. And send both of these. The thing would be to send the send. This is going to be weird, but let's go to the duplicate. Right click, 808 stack, route to this track only. Then go to your original 808, and then left click the 808 stack, but then left click the master. So all you hear is the 808 stack. And then here you can add like a limiter or a compressor, whatever you want. Let's do Fruity Soft Clipper. Where are we at? Fruity Soft Clipper. This is just to make sure it's not going to peak. Let's shorten the 808 out a little bit. It's a little too long. So it depends on like what type of sound you're going for. You can, there's infinite levels of distortion. The reason it does that stop and go effect, we have to hit Alt L to drag out the notes. Trying to give it a defined note length. Decent. Let's go down. So you can, so with your drums, let's go to the X-Kit at busyworksbeats.com. Let's load up a kick, like kick IH. It's really good over 808s. Let's grab a snare, snare EO, and let's grab some hi-hats. Let's make a simple trap rhythm, and then I'll show you how to program your drums to hit way harder. So flip your kick if you don't hear your kick. Oh, you know what? Duh, it's routed to the group. That's why. Let me reroute these. I was wondering why I couldn't hear the kick. So I'm going to make my drums a little more active. Kind of keep it consistent. We're not going to go too crazy with the drum snare on the 3 and 7 count. And we'll shorten out the snare. I'll show you how to do it. Just right click, fill each 2 steps. Now the hi-hats are going to go faster. Or you can use hi-hat rolls. So I'm going to roll it where the kick is hitting multiple times. Let's hit Alt A and drag the note out longer so it fills in that gap. me finish out the pattern. I didn't realize I didn't finish the pattern. So with the drums, let's route them to a mixer channel. All your kicks, your hi-hats, and your snares, right click, route to this track only. We're gonna run it through a Fruity Soft Clipper. Go to your threshold, and instead of, you could do it two different ways. I'm just gonna do it the easy way right now so I don't have to go to each element and boost them. Go to your Parametric EQ2, and then put this before the Fruity Soft Clipper and just use this as a gain knob and just drive the signal. You're gonna hear your drums get super crazy. Hold on. Now, keep in mind, this affects everything, so if you want to back off on it, just pull down your fader. So now your drums hit way harder. Let's add a soft clipper to the master. This is only just to prevent clipping. I wouldn't use this on your actual master track. Now let's start adding the atmospheric stuff. Last time we did a Ronnie J style, we ended up with that We Love track. We love. So that came out pretty dope. Let's open up Vintage Fire. Let's see how far we can take it. I'm just looking for a vibe. Vintage Fire is great for vibes. This is at busyworksbeats.com/vintagefire. It's our first plugin. It's built for lo-fi, hip-hop, rap, trap, hip-hop. I said hip-hop, R&B, mainly pop genres. And it has analog, authentic analog sounds for the digital world. So let's add this in. So I have to remember that we're going to add halftime. A little sharp, so let's go back to the Vintage Fire, pull down your pitch. All right, so let's make something go faster. Now this one's a little detuned, so let's switch the preset. There we go. So I'm gonna go. You'll see what the sound. I'm doing it this way because we're going to add halftime. Okay, let's add halftime. Let's add some stutters in here. You could use Gross Beat, but let's use Glitch 2 for a second. Only thing about glitch is that you can't offset it, at least from what I understand. So it's going to be very locked to the grid, and it's going to sound very quantized. So you just got to be careful with that. I could be wrong. I didn't read the manual. So. Let's blend halftime. It never hits that second note, so let's tell halftime to read for two bars. Switch out the sound. Let's get a different texture going. Go to your cogwheel, go to your wrench tool, turn up time shift. So the melody fits in the groove. Also keep in mind when you saturate your 808, it detunes a little bit. So that's why I had to pitch the 808 up just then. So the Halloween bells are super hard because they're not, like, the tune goes up and down throughout time, so you never know which note's gonna be on and which one's gonna be off. It creates this really haunted sound. Let's just turn up the reverb. I like this vibe. Go to Fruity Delay 3, turn your dry level all the way down, turn your feedback down, turn your time delay down, and then turn your modulation up. Then let's mess with the sample rate. Give it a little more edge. Add a regular delay, Fruity Delay 3. I just want to call back like dun, 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 bum, bum. So feedback on one. Add a little bit of a low pass. We'll be right back. it's all about letting the 808 kind of breathe. So let's mess with the 808 stack. Then you would add his vocal ideas on top. So let's find the key. Make sure we're in the right tuning as well. Because now the beat is all over the place. There's a big delay. I think that's, what did we add that caused a big delay? One of these plugins, probably the 808 chain. So it's gonna be hard to record because there's such a delay, but I'll try it. All we're doing right now is just mapping out the key. So I'm just trying to find the root note and the tuning. It's not at 440 hertz. So we're at 432 hertz tuning, which is different. To do this, you just subtract 31 cents from whatever the instrument you play. So what are we at? What am I doing here? Oh, we're doing auto-tune. Like, there's a huge lag, like tick, tick. It's like a 5 millisecond, not 5 milliseconds, but 20 millisecond difference. It says 60 milliseconds. So auto-tune has to be at 432 hertz tuning, which is 432.1, let's go there. Retune speed all the way up, maybe a little bit of flex tune, just not too much. Then you lock in your key, and then you pull up your key, which we had before, which I deleted. So I think it was all the white notes except F. I think that was our key. Let me see. Thank you. key. So I want to map that. This is our key. I want to map it out in auto tune. So all the notes that we're not using, I'm going to remove. A sharp, not in here. Pull auto-tune back to zero, so it's robotic. Why she said she loved me. Let's run this through some effects. Trying to think here. We need to send this. Let's do delay. Why she says she loves me? This is not my octave. Why she says she loves me? It's not my octave. Anyway, Fruity Reverb 2. What level all the way up? You know the movie trailers or the next one? Drums will be a little bit different, but this is just my style of drums. His will be a little more hi-hat focused, and it keeps rolling, versus mine are like emphasized drums. He might even record through some saturation. Let's try some saturation, like Isotope. Now I'm going to commit to the sound, so whatever we pick. You could use Isotope Exciter, kind of crank up these knobs, turn it to a tape, link these, turn it to tape.
Why she said she loves.
Let's pull these down.
Why she said she loves me. Yeah.
Now you're gonna hear all this background noise, but whatever.
Why she said she loves me.
So I'm just gonna record whatever. Get a general tone.
Why she said she loves me. You don't love me, then. Why she said she loves me. She never left me, yeah. I didn't know they loved me, yeah. Try to satisfy me, yeah.
Alright, so for some reason I'm not getting enough effects. Let's pull this down. We need a lot more delay and reverb. Let's add that.
She said she loves me. You don't love me, then.
I like the saturated song.
But she said she loves me. But she never loved me, yeah. But she told her something. I love you.
To take out this bouncy kick. Let's also switch out the snare. The other snare was kind of like making it feel like it's stopping. I think we need one more element to like make it more melodic. And then we'll do the vocal. Thank you. So I'm just trying a different effect. This one just kind of has to rely on the vocal, because if you stack up too many melodies, they get complicated. So now we gotta come up with a vocal idea. So I'm just gonna record improv. My voice is way deeper, so it's gonna be a whole different octave. So let's try it. And I feel like, let me go back to the hi-hats. I feel like the hi-hats stop at one. If we don't come up with anything, we don't.
Ooh, say she love me. When I drop the ceiling, this shit ugly, yeah. Ooh, she love me. Yeah, I drop the ceiling, this shit ugly, yeah.
I just realized something. I know why it sounds out of key. Melody has that thing on it. So that's thrown off the perception. Forgot I had that on. I'm also gonna record through a filter because my voice is so low that it's picking up too many low frequencies.
So she loves me.
ugly, we mean ugly in spirit, not physical.
Ooh, says she loves me. I've been popping pills, feeling ugly.
Excited, so I didn't commit to that. Trying to come up with a hook, but this is if I produce for it, so we do have to technically write a hook. On the gibberish.
I dropped it, I didn't try to sing. I didn't pop the floor, I tried to sing.
Fill that up with actual. So this is off because there's a delay, so I'm counter singing faster to compensate. I don't have a hook idea for this for whatever reason, probably because we don't have the additional melody. So I would sit with this longer, but I don't want to waste another hour sketching ideas. So this song would be like, I'm not even on beat because of the delay, but you know, that kind of fast rap.
I'm not afraid to die.
Keep in mind, this is not a master track. I would take more time in the mix, but I don't want to spend 2 hours on it. I'll play it twice through. We'll wrap it up. Wrap it up here. You can learn a lot more in the premium section at busyworksbeats.com. Let's continue the series If I Produce For. Thanks for watching today. Please let me know which artist or producer you want to go through next. It's busyworksbeats.com.